You have befouled the profession of teaching by accepting not only one, but two Teacher of the Year awards, despite not speaking a word of the foreign language you purport to teach. Like the storied predators of yesteryear will. You pick only the most vulnerable students to favor while actively neglecting the others. Like that gross kid with the dreadlocks. Or that poor Irish idiot, Rory. The black dancer, whose name none of us remember, because you rode his back to a win at sectionals and then promptly ignored him into oblivion. You positively worship a student if they can so much as carry a tune, and yet you don't know a single name of the only true musical geniuses in that choir room. The band! Who have demonstrated time and again that they can, at the drop of a hat, play literally any song you can name. And still, you treat them like so much nameless human garbage.
I can't tell you how much I hate those kids. Do you know how demeaning it is when they just turn to you and yell, "Hit it," and you're just supposed to know what song they're gonna sing? I'm free. Free.
So, I get it. My first idea was pretty bad.
Worse than funk.
Worse than Night of Neglect.
As national champions, we get to host the annual show choir rules committee meeting.
But please tell me you're gonna ask what one-third vintage meant last year.
Yeah, or like why some teams get to sing six songs and others only do one.
What is with you Glee Club expats? Don't any of you have jobs? You have to have some source of income so you can pay the staff of scientists who serve as your teleporters that you all clearly own since you're constantly showing up here.
You know what, Rachel? If you are still obsessing over what you're going to sing at your funny girl callback, may I suggest your best jam ever, Run, Joey, Run.
Run, Joey, run. Joey, run. Joey, run. Joey, run. Joey, run. Joey, run.
William, I have in my Spanx at all times a list of the worst songs ever performed by the Glee Club, and I would appreciate it if you would not reprise any of the following numbers. Number one, Run Joey Run. You should literally apologize to America for that one. Number two, the ingenious mashup of Crazy in Love and Hair. Now, I know you must have been pretty tired when you put that baby together.
I just think that it's insane that all Porcelain had to do to get an internship with Vogue.com is take photos of every ridiculous outfit he's ever paired with a Cossack hat and a see-through raincoat, and then show up at an interview where he is lauded as a visionary because his jod purse happened to match his riding crop.
Now, seeing as how your students in the Glee Club come and go for weeks at a time with no explanation whatsoever, I'm sure that it will not come to you as a surprise that we have an abysmal attendance record at this school.
Did you know there's a forum on my blog that's begging you to stop rapping?
Wait, the kids don't like it when I rap?
I just like you too much to put you in danger.
Santana broke up with you.
No, it's not just Santana. It's like all the lesbians of the nation. And I don't know how they found out about Santana and I dating, but once they did, they started sending me like tweets and Facebook messages on Lord Tubington's wall. I think it means a lot to them to see two super hot, popular girls in love. And I worry if they find out about you and I dating that they'll turn on you and get really violent and hurt your beautiful face and mouth. I'm Head Cheerio, Vice Rachel of the Glee Club, and now I'm planning a Middle East-style sham election that will install me as senior class president for life.
Brittany, who are you talking to?
I thought I was doing a voiceover.
Okay.
And with that, I said goodbye and swooped out the doorway, my voiceover continuing down the hallway.
In fact, that money ran out 6 weeks ago.
How?
Will Schuster's profligate spending and his penchant for staging elaborate private bacchanalia, replete with extravagant scenery and costumes not seen since the reign of Caligula. I have here a line item budget of the jungle set you constructed on stage a few weeks back so the Glee Club could perform a Katy Perry song, literally, for just you.
I got the eye of the tiger, the fighter, dancing through the fire.
I'm so ashamed of myself. She's turned me into her.
Look at me. Even in the heat of battle, I'm so elegant, regal. I am Ajax, mighty Greek warrior. God, it feels good to finally pop that zit known as Will Schuster.
Shut up, Sue. Look at us. We're even fighting in our voiceovers.
We have made the decision to make some lemonade out of these lemons and join together as a show choir supergroup.
And that the notion that two rival show choirs would suddenly just join forces out of nowhere is both morally repugnant
Inconvenient. Now, unlike some members of the Glee Club who come and go for months at a time with no explanation, you two losers are always in that choir room. Even if for an entire week, the only thing you have to do is say something inconsequential like, Kitty's writer. Blaine, are you serious?
The McKinley High Non-Denominational Christmas Club meeting is now called to order. Vice President Artie Abrams has the floor.
This Christmas Club looks an awful lot like Glee Club.
I'm here to inform you that Principal Figgins has made me in charge of judging the 50th annual Christmas tree decorating contest, a long-standing tradition here at McKinley High, even though we didn't do it last year. Or the year before. Or the year before that.
No, it's okay. You're welcome. I mean, you're going to have to audition. We have a very rigorous process.
I mean, not really. Sugamato is literally tone deaf.
Ben! A little time with me! Yeah!
Yeah, but she was hot.
Where did he get all these video clips?
I have cameras everywhere, Becky.
But is this like a dream sequence? How could you film that?
Okay, Becky. Shut up. You're ruining this, honey.
Joe, you haven't really made much of an impression on me, and I don't really know what your deal is.
I mean, there is that one black kid, but he's real boring.
Hey, Mercedes.
Yeah, hi. I'm a...
What invitational?
The one I organized to destroy the Glee Club once and for all. I said that out loud, didn't I? I should have said that in voiceover.
How are you trying to pick me up? Because if you're going to go Leslie with a cheerleader, I think the world's kind of rooting for you and Quinn Fabray.
See here? Right on schedule. Week 5. Plain friends again. We still have 6 more weeks for scheming, possibly 7, depending on network preemptions.